In this video, I will explain how to calculate the typical value for each category of a categorical covariate from the beta parameters estimated by monolics. In this example dataset, I have a genotype covariate for the CYP3A4 enzyme with three categories: AA for wild type, AG for heterozygous, and GG for polymorphic homozygous. I have tagged the CYP3A4 genotype column as a categorical covariate. As this genotype might be involved on the metabolism of the drug, I have added it on the clearance parameter here. To check what is behind this click, I can display the formula where we can see that the log of the clearance for each individual is equal to the log of CLPOP plus beta parameter in case CYP3A4 is equal to AJ plus another beta parameter in case CYP3A4 is equal to JJ plus the random effects. So here we see that my reference category that corresponds to the CLPOP is equal to AA, wild type, because this is the first one that appears in my dataset. If I want to change the reference category, I can add a new covariate by clicking on Discrete, allocate the different groups, and here choose which one is reference one, and I may also group some categories together. For the moment, I'm happy with AA wild type, so I can cancel this. Once the project has run, we can see in the results that these three parameters are estimated, CLPOP and the two beta parameters. So if I go back here to this equation, let's try to calculate the typical value for each category from the beta parameters. If I'm considering the wild type subgroup, then these two terms are dropping out, and these are the random effects. So the log of the typical values for the wild type group is just the log of CLPOP. So basically, the clearance in the AA group is the CLPOP parameter estimated by monolics. Then if I'm considering the heterozygous group, then log of the typical value of clearance for this group is log of the CLPOP parameter plus the beta parameter. If I take the exponential of this formula, I obtain this one here, and that's how I can calculate the clearance for the heterozygous category based on the CLPOP and beta parameter estimated in monolics. And the same exactly applies also for the third category for the polymorphic homozygous group. So that's how to work for a log normal distribution as we have for clearance generally. On the next slide, I have written the equations also for a normal distribution. That's really straightforward. And for a logit distribution where the formula is a bit more complex. These formulas are also available on our website that you can find via this link here. Have a nice week.